Hi guys. First of all, I have to say I'm sorry that it took so long to make the 10th vlog, but as you see, everything is green. I'm not in Vegas. I'm in Germany on vacation, but the time that you're gonna see the video, I'll be back in Vegas, and I'll bring some more footage up in the future for sure. Because it's the 10th vlog, I want to give you a little bit, a little special. So I have a special category. When people come to Las Vegas for a poker vacation, they always ask me, where's the best place to play? Where's the best action? Which poker room is the best? And I always answer that it depends on your game. I can't tell you where is the best game. Normally, every single poker room has good games. It depends on the timing that you have and if there's a good game for you, for your strategy. Playing live and playing online is totally different. The problem is, you don't have a fish tracker or a poker tracker for the live games, so you have to use your own skills to find the right table with the fish that you want to get the money from. In general, I would say the 1-3 games are a little bit higher played before the flop than the 1-2 games. Even the big blind is just $1 more, the raises before the flop are normally between $12 and $18, and the 1-2 games are in the normal games are around $8 to $15. I prefer the 1-3 game. There's normally a little bit more action. The raises before the flop should be in that range. If it's not in that range, if they just raise to $5-6 or less, I'm not playing in that game because this is not the game that I want to like to play in. If it's higher, even better. Also, I would say that the off-strip casinos, they are not on the strip, on the main strip or downtown. They have normally a little tighter games. We got loser games on the strip. These are local casinos where normally the local players go to play, and they prefer to play limit anyway. So the most of the games that they have in these casinos are limit games. But like I said before, you can always find a good game even in that local casinos. Okay, it's time to get a little bit into the details. Which poker room should I choose? I personally like to play on the strip casinos because it takes me less than 10 minutes and I sit in the next poker room. You can easily walk from casino to casino on the strip. In general, I would say the more fancy hotel casinos in Las Vegas, like the Wynn, the Bellagio, the Aria, they normally have the clientes that have more money in the pocket and they normally play higher, but sometimes they play in the 1-2 or 1-3 games also. So you can find the people with more money in the pocket normally in these places. But still, the other games like the 1-2 or 1-3 games at a little bit cheaper casinos like the Flamingo, the Luxor, the Excalibur, you still can find good games in these poker rooms too. Also, I would recommend always look online or in the weekly newspapers that come in Las Vegas. About conventions. There are some casinos that have really big convention centers, and if you have a Sony convention or a doctor convention, something like this, these people have a lot of money and they always play poker also, so the games are really good then too. Also, when there are tournaments, bigger tournaments for pool or dart players, I love to play against them because that means normally you have a lot of action in these games. I personally like to play on the strip casinos because it takes me less than 10 minutes and I sit in the next poker room. You can easily walk from casino to casino on the strip. There's a difference between playing nighttime and daytime also. On daytime, normally all the old school guys sit on the table. And for me, that's a little bit nitty. Most of the time when I sit down on daytime, I'm the youngest player on the table. It's a different game, and I really prefer to play nighttime because all the young guns playing at nighttime, sometimes before they go to the club to just get some cheap drinks on the table and get drunk and then go to the club. So when you finally find the poker room you want to play in, now it's most important, find the right table. First thing you do is looking at the tables. Most important in poker for me is table selection. And the table selection, take your time. Put your name on the board when you come to the poker room. Put your name on the waiting list. Even there is no list, just put the name on there and you're first up when there is a seat open. Even if you don't know anything about the table that you're looking at, there is a lot of stuff that you can see that makes your decision easier if this table is good for your game or not. Easy. Number one. How many players are sitting on the table? Is it a short game? Is it a full game? Most of the poker rooms have 9 or 10 handed for the cash game. Normally it's 9 handed. Some of the poker rooms have 10 handed cash games also. So have a look. If you don't like to play shorthanded, I like for my game I have to have at least 7 players on the table. How old are the players on the table? Normally I prefer to have a good mix of the table, but older people normally are more nitty than the younger ones. The younger ones are more known for action. How many women are sitting on the table? For me personally, I don't want more than 2 girls on the table because I wouldn't say that they play better or worse than guys, but in general I would say they are more tight than the guys. The first thing I'm gonna do when I come to the poker room is I look around if I knew the supervisor, the poker room manager, or if I see some dealers that I know, and I go talk to them to get some information about the games. Normally they tell me if the table 5 is a really good game or table 7 has 3 drunk guys on there. So that's the kind of information that I want to make it easier to make the decision to choose the table. You should also look at the board if there are some specific table changes for a specific table. That normally means this is a good game. If other players wants to sit in that game, you should have a look at that game and might go on the list that also. Number 4. What kind of drinks do they have in front of them? Water? Not good. Coffee? Not good. You want to have people that drink beer or wine or better shots. That's the best ones. So you want to play against the drunk guys. What kind of clothes are the players wearing on the table? You have players there that go normally out with the normal, they're sitting there with normal clothes that everybody's wearing, but you have people there, they sit there with nice suits or nice dresses. And you have people there, they are really showing everybody, hey, I'm a poker player. They wear a hoodie, they wear a hat, they wear shorts, and these are the worst ones with the shorts and the slippers or the slippers. You can say right away these guys are poker players. How do players stack the chips in front of them? Normally they stack $5 chips up to 100, so 20 chips up to 100. But some of the players stack the chip differently, and they're using they're making a line on the side. That normally means that they not giving away the money that easy. Also, if they cap the chips like you see in the photos, These players are normally don't like to play too many hands. Look at the stacks on the table. You need a lot of chips on the table. That's the best one. You don't want to have people sitting down with just $50 or $60. If you have 7 or 8 of them, there's no money on the table, then the pots normally don't get that big.
Not good. That's better. Perfect.
Also, you can see if they advanced poker players that play every day, how they handle the chips. I try to show you, but I'm not so good in the stuff with the chips. So, like the playing with the chips is not my favorite. The only thing that I can do is the shuffle thing. So, and that's even that's. You can go down a little bit with the camera. Thank you. Even that's. Not something that I'm really good in, but many of my friends can do that rollover shit. I don't know. I can't do that, okay? If you see somebody flipping the chips around, that's normally somebody who's spending a lot of time on the tables. Okay. Also, the way how the player bets the chips. You cut the chips before you make your bet. Normally in Las Vegas everybody cuts the chips 25s. Unadvanced players, they just take the stack and go like this. So these players are normally not playing every day. Okay, now I want you to bet $36. Okay, ich möchte jetzt, dass du $36 setzt. Perfect. Okay, that's called a string bet. It's not, you can't do that. What I want you to do is bet $36. Okay. What the fuck? 36. I want you to bet $36.
36?
Mm-hmm. Shuffle the check. No, no, make a real chip trick. Another one? Okay, another one?
Next.
You can see if it is an advanced player also, how he looks at the cards, or if he's... if he plays cards a lot or not. So the normal players look the cards like this, so they cover the cards. Some of the players go like this or like this. The best ones that I'm looking for are these ones. That's the ones I want to play against. You also should listen to the language the people talk, then you can find out if there are tourists. So people talk like me, like with an accent, they're normally not from Vegas. You also should look at the loudest table in the room. That normally is the table where they have the most fun, they are screaming, they're laughing, they giving high fives. That's normally the table you want to sit on because the action is most of the time the best.
Ha 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 ha.
Get the hell out of here.
This one.
Get the hell out of here.
No,
I'm
don't.
Working.
No, I don't.
I'm working.
So what? Hello.
No respect. One thing that you should look at is also how big are the pots when you see a showdown. So always stay on the table till you see a showdown and look at the pot size.
This is not good. This is okay. This is perfect.
Look at the showdowns and look at the reactions from the other players on the table. Sometimes you can pick something up from earlier hands when they go like, "What the fuck? This is the third time you're calling me with second pair." Or, "You're chasing the flush draw the fifth time and you always hit the flush draw." Something like this. If the dealer drops three cards at one time, you should go to
drop the cards.
Perfect is when the dealer always...
Did you hear what he said?
Yeah, I heard what he said. Seid jetzt mal ruhig, ihr Ulisse. One time with professionals. Only one time, please. Does the dealer always have to explain what to do? When the dealer has to explain all the time the rules again to a player, that normally means that the player has no clue. Obviously. So, in the meantime, I'm back in Vegas. I hope you liked a little bit my short video about table selection. Don't take it too serious. It's just a thought for me, for you when you go and look for the right table. Like I said, you can always find a good table. And if it helps you to pick at least one point that I told you you can use, or you remember that you watched my video when you go and look for the next table, that's fine. If you had fun, that's even better. And so now I have some examples before I finish this vlog. I have some examples that you should look for and some that you have to avoid. Don't play against these players, or yes, pick these players. So I see you next time. Yeah. Bye bye. Oh yeah, and don't miss the outtakes on the end. Have fun.
I race blind. All in. What is a straddle?
Ja, so schlimm ist es nicht. Okay. Hi guys, I just want to tell you I'm stupid. No. Nochmal neu. Das ist scheiße, ich kann nichts machen, wenn jeder die ganze Zeit auf mich draufgeiert wie so Spezialiste. Dann bin ich jetzt durcheinander. Many of them come to me and ask me, where can I find if a blablabla. Fuck. Playing poker online or playing poker live is totally fucking shit. There is a big difference between
My eyes cover.
Who is this evil sound tiger?
One time with professionals. Only one time, please.
Wo ist das Baby?
Da ist das Baby! Mensch, mach aus!
What is a straddle?
I have no idea.
Nee, du musst das sagen, du Depp. What is a straddle? Sag schon.
Das kann ich dir nur für Englisch erklären.
Doch, nee, du sollst halt, du sollst fragen, what is a straddle?
Ach so.
Einmal mit Profis, einmal.